carbon footprint. You're hungry, right? Would you like an apple?
Mm-hmm.
Well, you just have to choose between these or these. They look the same, don't they? But they aren't. There's something that makes them different, and that is their carbon footprint. You don't know what a carbon footprint is? Listen closely. Dinosaurs lived on Earth millions of years ago, and they left footprints like these. What will human footprints be like? Surely, they will be more like this. Dinosaur footprints are just marks on the ground. Those of human beings are spread all over because they are made up of concrete, asphalt, fumes, and smoke. Our biggest footprint on the planet is all the pollution that we introduce into the atmosphere, which is the result of burning fossil fuels. This pollution accumulates in the atmosphere and is made up mainly of carbon dioxide. It creates a layer that prevents solar radiation from being reflected back into space and makes the temperature of the Earth rise dangerously. That's why the amount of polluting gases that we release into the atmosphere with our activity is known as our carbon footprint. Hilde has an apple orchard. She collects the apples and takes them to a nearby market herself. Hilde's activity hardly produces any polluting fumes. Her carbon footprint is small, but some farms are highly mechanized like this one. A single machine can harvest a huge field, and to do that, it consumes a lot of energy. Big machines collect fruit, treat it in a factory, take it to the other side of the planet, wrap it up in plastic, and put it on sale. The carbon footprint of these apples is made up of the pollutants produced by the burning of all the fuel that has been needed for their cultivation, treatment, and their transportation. Harvesters, trains, boats, trucks have produced all of this carbon dioxide so that Benito can find his favorite fruit in the supermarket. Oh, and not only that, Benito goes shopping by car. If we add up all of the carbon dioxide produced so that these apples can reach our table, from the harvester, transportation, processing plant, more transportation, and Benito's vehicle, it turns out that our snack has produced all of these polluting fumes and gases. And all of these polluting fumes and gases that we produce in our daily lives are our carbon footprint. In less than a century, the world's population has multiplied by 4. We use millions of polluting vehicles, and our carbon footprint has only grown and grown. It has reached a record level on planet Earth, unknown for the last 3 million years. And that growing carbon footprint heats up the climate and threatens to extinguish life on Earth. But there's still something we can do to prevent our own extinction. Do you want to know what it is? We should simply generate less carbon dioxide, reduce private transport, use clean and renewable energy, and choose products that don't need to be transported across the world or from massive industrial farming. In short, we must try to consume local products that do not generate a large carbon footprint. And now, tell me, which apples do you prefer? You still don't know? How about like this? Be smart. If you choose products with a lower carbon footprint, you help fight global warming.